Ariane here from the Movement Paradigm. Today I'm going to talk about high intensity interval training. So this is often a good topic around the holidays because most people are interested in getting fit as fast as they can. So I wanted to talk about the pros and cons of high intensity interval training and hopefully help you educate yourself on making the most informed decision of whether or not it's appropriate for you. So let's start with what it is. So essentially it is going to be a vigorous activity followed by a low to moderate intensity activity in an interval format that is often done between 5 minutes up to 30 minutes. And the intervals can range from 15 seconds to 2 to 3 minutes, or even, you know, give or take. So there's lots of options to do high intensity interval training, and it can be done with body weight and calisthenics. It could be done with free weights. It could also be done on a machine such as an elliptical or stair climber or something like that. So let's first talk about some of the benefits of it. So the first is you can have a decrease in body fat. So some of the well-researched benefits are, you know, very promising as it relates to HIIT training. Of course, body fat being a really important one for all of us, that has been shown to help decrease body fat as well as improve overall metabolic rate. So metabolic rate is really important because that helps you to burn more during the course of the day when you're not working, right? So that's always really powerful. It also helps to improve oxygenation, which is the muscle's ability to use oxygen. So that's really powerful because oftentimes we think of steady state, long duration cardio, where it's been found that you can do less actual work. So 60 minutes compared to 120 minutes on average, that can have the same benefit as, you know, running for, again, 120 minutes a week versus 60 minutes of high intensity training. So it can be really powerful, which leads me to my next point, is that you get a lot of benefit for a little bit of time. So you get maximum benefit for decreased time investment. So as we are all super busy and stressed and, you know, all of those factors, because we don't have enough time in the day, it can be very valuable. It has been shown to also increase muscle growth. However, that is not the gold standard of muscle building, which would be really strength training. So although there has been some benefits, really it's not the most valuable way to do that. So just kind of keep that in mind as well. So let's kind of shift gears and talk a little bit about some of the disadvantages. So one of the things is that it can lead to a higher injury risk. Some of the reasons why I think that is it happens is because a lot of the people that choose to do high intensity training sometimes are deconditioned at first, and they think, oh, this is a really fast way to get in shape. So they begin doing it at a high volume, high intensity, and, you know, oftentimes don't have a solid movement foundation or a fitness foundation to support it. So I think that's a really important part, is to make sure that you're kind of doing it in succession. So the disadvantages can be that it also you can have a poor recovery time. So when you're thinking of high intensity training, sometimes I've heard that people are doing it 4 to sometimes 6 days a week. Which in my opinion is really, really high, because you need a lot of time to recover from that high intensity training session. So think of it as it is a stressor, a physical stressor on your body. And when you have a higher amount of stress on your body, then you need more recovery time, right? So you wanna be able to think about that. Is I typically recommend my patients do it no more than twice a week. However, you know, maybe 2 to 3 times at max. So I think that's a, you know, really important part too. And then lastly is specificity. So if you are training for a sport, if you're training for a movement skill, you need to make sure that you're really still focusing on the specificity. So high intensity training is not geared towards specificity whatsoever. It is general conditioning. So you just wanna, you know, think about that. And then the last kind of take-home point that, you know, might help draw it together a little bit is when I'm, you know, saying to one of my patients that I think this is really going to benefit them, and then to another patient, I don't think this is really appropriate. These are the things that I consider in this person to make sure that it's an appropriate prescription for this particular client or patient. And one of the first things I'm looking at is, you know, is this person experiencing a tremendous amount of chronic stress in their life, maybe acute or chronic stress in their life? If so, I do not recommend high intensity training, because again, it is a stressor. Although exercise can be a positive stressor, it doesn't matter. It still is having an effect on your body, physiological effect. So if someone's experiencing that, I do not recommend that at that time. If someone is just a beginner, I do not recommend high intensity training. My goal for them is to really learn how to move, learn about their body, learn to, you know, really understand what's happening and be able to respond appropriately to, is this discomfort, is this pain, you know, really just getting in tune with their body, and also just developing a basic level of fitness, a basic level of cardiovascular fitness, a basic level of strength before I, you know, add a lot of volume and intensity, where a lot of times they can't necessarily focus on all those things at one time. So that's kind of how I will decide, you know, who is a good candidate for it or not. If someone is, you know, has been working out for a while, they kind of want to take things to the next level, they want to really boost their cardiovascular fitness, I think it can be really valuable. So again, you know, nothing is black and white as always, and it's really just about understanding, you know, the pros and cons of something, and is this appropriate for you at this time in your life, right? And if it is, you know, there's a lot of well-researched benefits. If it's not, then just hold off and maybe revisit it and just focus on kind of the basics. You know, I'm a huge believer, and I can speak for probably a lot of my colleagues that are in the movement world, is that, you know, movement is a skill that you keep refining all the time. You know, there's so much to learn, and there's never this kind of stopping point like, okay, now I'm fit and I'm just gonna move forward. Like, you really wanna continue that journey forever. So there's always things to get better at. So I hope this is helpful. And if you have any questions, as always, please reach out. Thank you, bye.